All right, so let's get into it. Again, this stream is being sponsored by Microsoft. Let's kind of start with a quick review. We are making a game hit the bricks. This is like that statistical overview. It shows you like the different API calls that are happening, it tells you like unique users that have accessed your game in X amount of time, the amount of logins. It's just a really cool tool to kind of monitor how your game goes. You can even see where people will be playing your game, which I think is super dope. Multiplayer is another cool thing that you can do with PlayFab, but that is just kind of the beginnings of it. So our game is called Hit the Bricks. Here is our game. This is something else really cool about PlayFab. You can connect to it directly in Unity. We went over the process for that last stream. We are going to look really quickly at our game manager here. Our game manager just basically helps us manage the game. Just to give you a very, very, very brief look at what the heck all of this is, if you're not familiar with code, basically this is what makes our game go. When the game turns on, it loads all of the different game objects and says, don't destroy them because we want to use them eventually and we want this game to run, you know, a little quicker. At start, we start a new game. This is a function here. So you start the game with 3 lives and a score of 0 and you load level 1. I actually did a naming convention so that all the system has to do is enter in what level you're going to and it will pull that level. So when a scene loads, it says, all right, we're gonna call our scene manager, which is an actual Unity library, and it will load scene. Then the scene it's gonna load is going to say level. It's going to look for level, and then whatever you pass into here for this integer. So this becomes a 1. It'll look for level 1, which is exactly what we want because that is what it is named in Unity. All of this mess here basically means it's going to go into PlayFab here. It says, I need title ID, blah, 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 blah. This is my title ID, so that is what I would put in there. It is going to ask to create an account. So we're going to change this script here to make it call from Twitch. For this, we want to use Twitch. So instead, we are calling the login with Twitch request. We are going to actually see how this works. I already preset it up. If we go to, oh, how did I do this before? It is actually running the script that we just kind of set. But basically it's not actually running to anywhere but here, because like I said, we're just testing it right now to make sure all the systems work. But here's where you can actually log in with Twitch. Does it work? No, not right now, because it's connected to like a local host. Back to our block breaker. So this is our actual game. Currently looks like this. This is the game view. So this is what our player would be seeing when they play this game. So we're gonna call this paddle. And this script is something we're gonna put literally right directly on this item right here. So brief look into what the heck all of this is. We are going to make a new script. We're going to drag it onto our paddle. Yeah, we just need the Unity engine. We're not going to use any of these system collections. So the first thing we're going to do, we're talking about adding in a rigid body. So we go back into our paddle. We're going to add a component, rigid body 2D. All right, so it's already attached to our paddle, so yay. So basically, these things give us physics. Box collider means that if an object touches this, if something else with a box collider touches this item, it'll say, hey, something's touching it. What do you want me to do? And then in the script, you can actually tell it what to do. Yeah, this is the rigid body here is helping us move. So this will help our paddle move left and right. And then the box collider will help the ball bounce off of it. We're going to go in here and we are going to make a public because we want everyone to be able to access it. Rigid bodies, we're going to call that rigid body. We are calling another awake function. So this is what the paddle does when the game awakens. Add physics. So public. But basically, this is helping our paddle move back and forth. And in here, with input, get key code. The sentence now says, if the input is A or if the input is left arrow, the paddle, this direction is left. The paddle goes left. And this is what we call direction. I think that's all we need to make our paddle move, if I am not mistaken. Yes, physics! Unity makes it pretty intuitive to actually add them in. So let's see what they're adding in next here. Private void fixed update, which is another Unity integrated function. So this direction, if this direction does not equal zero. You're basically adding force to whatever direction is currently happening. So direction, left or right, times our speed, which is currently, look at all my folders. Look at how organized I am. Wow, look at me. We did this last stream. Give it a box collider because it needs to hit it. Let's just kind of put it here because I know for a fact that it's a little bit under this paddle. We're going to put it right under here. All right, this one, we're going to rotate it. Tedious work. Oh, the joys of game design. And last but not least, wall right. And then we're going to move it. That's not half bad. It worked. But yay, we added the first of our physics. So now our paddle moves left and right, which we did that, y'all. We did that. Our paddle is moving. Now we just need to give our ball some physics. So let's look into this real quick. Oh, we're making everything zero, I think. Yeah, we're zeroing out everything in the paddle. Okay, so I was actually right about that. Fun fact, I was right. This helps us with, you know how our thing was like speeding around earlier? This gives it some mass so that it can't just zip around all over the place. All right, so if we go into the rigid body constraints, we can actually freeze the positions here. So we want to freeze our X, so our left and right, so this way. So now our little thing won't drop anymore. New script. This is going to be everything that controls our ball. We don't need, if I'm not mistaken, we only need the Unity engine. That is correct. We can get rid of everything else. We're calling the rigid body. So now we're going to drag this onto here. So now it's like, I'm not attached to anything. I don't know what rigid body you're talking about. Now it does because we put the script on the ball. All right. So very similar to last time, we're going to make a function to, on awake, we're going to grab that rigid body and then we're going to make our start. And so now we're going to add force. It's saying we don't have any at the current point in time. We're adding some force to it after the game starts. So we're gonna make the ball, it's also going to have a speed of 30. We are multiplying the force times the speed, so this little asterisk is just means multiplied by. Scripts are sorcery. They are. But you know, when you actually break them down, they're not actually that scary. We are adding force at the beginning of this function, at the start. So this is going to be the thing that I think if I remember how brick breakers work, this is going to be the thing that makes our ball go wee boing and bounce off and start the game. But basically the randomizer means it's just going to go in any direction, either that way or that way to hit the thing. But now when we start the game, the ball will start going in a certain direction between -1 and 1. So we're probably not going to get to the bounce part today. So we have the very, very beginnings of our game. The ball drops right down onto our paddle. And depending on which way we move the paddle after that, we add in our bounce, it'll go that direction. And when we fix our walls, it'll bounce off the walls. And then we're going to add if functions probably for what happens with the bricks when they're hit. The next step will be y'all being able to log into this game and actually play it yourselves, which I'm so excited about. So we still have a little ways to go, even for a simple game like this, there is a lot of background work that goes into it. But yeah, that's all we're gonna dive into today.